What do you think it is so special about Ethiopian music? I mean, what differentiates it from music from other parts of the world?
Well, you know, I mean, usually culture is the identity of a nation. There are different kind of great nations in the world which have their own identity, their own music, their own way of playing their instruments and everything. So is Ethiopia. Ethiopia, as I've said before, the culture is so rich and our contribution is so great to the world. But there are some areas where there is some kind of similarity to the other music in the world. Not totally, but there is a similarity. Like if we take like the chichika, it's found in Mombasa, they have chichikas, they have West Africa, they have chichikas. Nigeria, Ghana, and all those places have the chichika. But it's like the way we play it, the way we play it makes it Ethiopian. So every part in the world, their way they play their music, their feelings, makes it their own. So what makes it really different from the other part of the world is the way we approach our music, the way we play, and the way we feel it. So that's the identity of a culture in the world. So that's how we feel and that's how we play. So it's beautiful, different and nice.
How about the tones? Like Ethiopian music, in Ethiopian music there are five tones, diatonic?
Yes, five tones, yeah. But also the five tones also are found in different parts of the world. But it's how we approach it. Like most of the Asian countries, like if you go to Chinese, the Japanese, this, they have five tone scales like us. But what makes it so different is the way we approach it, the way we feel those scales. We feel it a different ways than the other countries feels it. And that's what it makes it typical and really Ethiopian. It's how we feel and that's how we are. But five tones are found other parts of the world as well. But just as I said, it's how we approached it. That's what makes it different in the world.
Okay. So how did you come up with your concepts of fusing Ethiopian style with jazz?
Well, that's a very interesting question. Well, actually, I used, I say like 5 tone against 12 tone. That's the basic concept of the Ethio jazz. But usually, when you are mixing 2 cultures or 3 cultures, you really have to be careful that one doesn't dominate the other one. So what it makes Ethio jazz is so interesting, even though I use different elements, different cultures, but I make sure that our modes, our melodies, our feelings, and our approach to those modes is kept right there. So that's what really makes Ethio jazz liked in different parts of the world, because the element is there, the identity is there, but it has been surrounded by beautiful 12-tone music, beautiful bass lines, and counterpoints, and also when you are improvising on those the 12-tone scales, I make sure that the color and the modes of the Ethiopian scales is not destroyed. So that's what really makes Ethio jazz beautiful. Well, you know, it's now, as I said, it's about like 42 years now. And it really became a big name in the world because of these fusions, because of its the approach and the different sounds I go through of these arrangements and compositions. And now it's been used, for example, the Broken Flowers films of the Hollywood film. And on the film was like, you know, there was Bill Murray and Sharon Stone on the Hollywood film. And the background music was the Ethio Jazz, which is really made it big all over the world, of the film, which is called The Broken Flowers. It's a Hollywood film. So somehow it was hard work, but it's interesting introducing our country, our music, in a modern concept of the Ethiopia, the modern concept of Ethiopia. And I've been traveling all over the world, and very successful concerts, and I'm still going now.
Okay, I think there's something special about your jazz arrangements, Ethio jazz arrangements, that is mixing it with Latin versions or something.
Yeah, but you see the problem, to my opinion, there isn't such a thing called Latin. It's all African. I don't think Latin when I do this music. I think African. Those rhythms which is found on this music are basically African rhythms. Now you can take any African drummers, anything to any southern part of America, and you just take them and you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, they can play together, which means that's our roots. And whenever we have the chance, we have to promote our roots to the world. That's African element.
Okay, I think it's now time for a song, so it's you who's going to choose the song.
Wow. Let me see, think. How about Buzinish Bakala?
That'll be fine.
Yeah,
okay.
That'll be great. Yeah.
Okay, enjoy your stay with us. Thank you.
Baby.